Okay, so today I'm going to show you how to make your thumbprint art. So on the screen you can see this is a finished product. I have my title on the side over here, and it's a quotation mark, so that lets my reader know that it's the name of the poem. I also have each of the letters capitalized for the words. And on the side is the name of the poet or whoever made the poem. So in order to create this, you're going to need some materials. First, you're going to need your draft materials. So again, you already have this one here. You made it just like this. You also made the lines very lightly, because as you can see, you're going to have to erase them once the words are put on. Okay, so you have your draft, and on the back, this is actually what has been typed on this one, and then this is what I transfer over to my thumbprint. So for right now, I'm going to take my draft and put that away, take my final copy and work with this one. I also need some other materials. I'm going to need a pencil, a ruler, a pen. My pen is blue, but your pen can be any color. I need a nice eraser and color pencils and a sharpener for my color pencils. I don't suggest you use marker unless they're fine tipped markers, just because as you can see, the writing is normal size and you need to fit a lot of writing in a small amount of space. So if you use markers, they might bleed or be too wide. If you have some colored pens, you could use those and those would look very nice. Okay. So the first thing we're going to do is do the title around the edge. So you're going to take your ruler and make a 1-inch margin around the edge. You want to use very light lines, because again, these lines are going to be erased when you're all finished. This next part is optional. I like to do some guiding lines so that when I make my letters, they line up very nicely. This is an art piece and it's a final project, so it should be your best work. And if you prefer to measure these, you may, or you can just eyeball it as I'm doing it right now. And again, my title is I Am From These Memories, but if your title is different, you want to make sure you put whatever your title is. Plain title, and sometimes it's really nice to start with a plain title and then put some kind of extra font on it. This is one that I like to do. It's very easy. But of course, you can use any font that you like. This is not formal writing, so your writing, of course, does not have to be in Times New Roman. When you type or when you draw. Okay. So my first step is done. My next step is to put my name on the side. And again, this is your name, not your teacher's. You can put your first and last name. My next step is to take my pen and begin to write my poem on my print. If you tend to make a lot of mistakes in your writing, you can use a pencil first, or you just go slowly and be careful, because once you do pen, it's difficult to go back. The way I'm going to start is I'm going to start right here with this A, and I'm going to start making these lines, and I'll go around my whole thumbprint like that, and then wherever it stops, I'll pick up again, and then I'll start writing on my lines. So you can see that on mine, my first stanza, I was able to go around my entire thumbprint. If my handwriting had been bigger or my words had been too far apart or something, I might not have had enough space, which is actually fine. And then what I would do in that case is I would just probably wrap the words up over the first part of the poem. So the next thing I want to do, in my first draft, you'll notice it's slightly different. I have exactly enough space, but here I had a little bit more space. So instead of keeping it blank, what I did is I just put dots to indicate that that was the end and I was still using that space. So if that happens to you, you can just put dots over the small spot, or if it ends up being a long spot until you get to where you started, what you can do is just start the first stanza. Now, I'm going to start my next stanza on my first line. Okay, and now I finished this stanza, and I have the other, just a little bit less than half of the poem left. But you can see I've taken up a lot of my thumbprint. And so there's a couple of things I can do. If I'm in fear that I'm not going to fit it, I can add some extra lines in here, or write smaller, or just be okay with either not finishing it on the inside and having to put some on the outside. That's another option. So then this part right here, on my poem it says, I believe no one should make fun of others, be alone, or be ungrateful. And then on my poem, all I could fit was make fun of others. I could have added an extra line if I was really worried about squeezing it all in there, or I could have stopped there and put a period and then not include that part. And then I'm going to start with, I believe we should all. Accidentally skip this line here, so I'm going to go ahead and I can either just draw the line straight, or I can put some dots. Some people like to put little designs, such as little hearts or something, but just something so it indicates that the line continues on. If you want to add an extra line to your poem right there, just to take up that space, you can do that as well. Okay, and it looks like I have this whole section, this whole stanza, but I don't have much space, so I'm going to modify it. I think I have just enough space for maybe I do, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 more lines. And I could probably squeeze one in here. So 1, 2, maybe 3. So I'm going to say, I am from these memories, I am from these beliefs, and I'll see how much space. It's okay that I didn't finish it all on here, because when I get finished, I'm going to take this, my very finished product, and actually I'll use my first example, and then I'm going to put this one on the back of it, just like this, so that eventually when I put it all together, people will be able to read the whole poem. All right, the next step I need to take is I need to do the same thing I did here around the edges. I need to put it in pen so that I can erase all of the pencil marks. If you did not capitalize your title or put in quotation marks, since it's a poem, now would be a good time to do so. Okay, and then my next step is to use that big eraser that you were keeping and erase all of the pencil lines. Now when you do this, you might want to wait a second, because sometimes the ink needs a little bit of time to dry. And once it's smudged, it's difficult to go back. Also, when you erase, you don't want to erase like you would normally on a piece of paper, just going back and forth, because what could happen is you go one way, and then when you come back, you accidentally start wrinkling your paper. So I suggest, it stays nice and neat, just use the side of your eraser and erase like this. It might take a little bit more time than it would normally, but you are much less likely to wrinkle your paper if you do it this way. Thank you. go back and see if there are any lines that you want to erase just a little bit. So I'm going to use my colored pencils and I'm going to color my lines. On my first draft, you can see that it is in the color of a rainbow. There's green and blue and pink and red and orange. And before I started, I decided ahead of time that I wanted to do the outer edge in one color and then alternating colors on the inside. And so my first stanza is all in green around the edge. My next line, I am from stacks of, and since I couldn't finish it, I went down here, and so that first part is all in yellow. So I am from stacks of shoes by the front door is all in yellow. My next line, ping pong in the living room, is then in blue. Lots of warm evenings by the, and then fire is right here, so I did all that part in a pinkish or a red color. So you are free, of course, to do whatever colors you like, but good luck on your project.